Good day. So we have here a sharp washing machine, which is a self-folding board, and it's lying around the garage for around a couple of years now. So the board is missing. I already removed the board. I'm looking for a replacement board for this type of fully automated washing machine. So I found later on that there is a universal washing machine board that we can use in this old washing machine. So it has, along with it, a panel board. Okay, this is the motherboard and this is the panel board. We will not be using the old panel board because we have a different ready schematic diagram or a different fully automated washing machine board. Okay? Of course, first things first, we need to clean up the washing machine before we fully fix the washing machine. So when cleaning the washing machine, we will be using a damp cloth. Surely we will be wiping out it first with a soap and second with a clean washcloth. Take you around to the washing machine. Okay, this is the washing machine. Okay, so at the back, the back portion, we can see the electrical illustration or what we call the wiring diagram. Okay, now here are the things that we need. We need the schematic diagram, the illustration at the back, so we printed it out. We need the connector, so we'll be cutting out the wires and replacing it with a new connector that is suitable for the new board. So we have your board. And we have your bonus water switch. Okay, it is provided with the board as we purchase it. We need here screwdrivers. We have the Phillips screwdrivers and the slotted screwdriver, and also a wire stripper and a cutter. And sometimes we also need, together with the long nose pliers, to hold the wire when we are stripping. And also provided in the box of this universal board is its own schematic diagram. So now we will be performing wire splicing. Okay, so here we are. As we finally find it, now we find that this number 7, which is a switch of water level, is not actually a red wire but a blue one, and the switch of the door switch is both color red, as you can see in the actual. Okay, remove the camera so you can see. So this is the switch. Okay, the switch, the door switch. As you open the door, there would have no continuity. You close the door, there will be have a continuity. Well, this is the water level switch. Okay. This is the water level. They are both color blue. And as we look into the connector, so the electric connector, as you can see, is number 9. Number 9. Okay. Number 9 is the electronic program controller. So it's the board. It's just like this, but the board is already gone and missing. So it's color white and color blue. So this is the blue, this is the white. But as you can see, it has red and blue but here we have just both blue wires, and here we have both red wires. Okay, so after application, and we have here
the power source. This is connected to the mains. Actually connected to our mains. And the purple one is connected to our motor. Okay, it's connected to our motor and our assembly capacitor. And the orange and red is the connector of the drain. And the incoming water valve. Okay, so this is the incoming water valve. Okay. So what we're going to do, we're going to remove the wiring so we can have all the wiring. The problem is we have your the new board. We have two wires connector for the door, and we have three wires connected to the water level sensor. Okay, so what we're going to do, we'll remove this electrical tape coating the wire. Now we have here the red and the light blue, so the red and the light blue, which is the this line is our drain motor. Okay, we have here the water level sensor and the door switch, and the orange is the water inlet bulb, so water inlet bulb, and we have here now the our main source. So the configuration of the washing machine, our drain tractors, we don't have a tow, it's just drain in a common, or drain and a zero. And our water level sensor, as you can see here, we have just the two wires, the two blue wires, this is our water level. Or in case we can use the water level sensor provided by the universal water board. So we can use the water level, only two levels, is either the low or the high. So this water level is sensing high or low water level sensors. So now we are gonna place the end connector, the terminals. Okay, so the female terminal at the end of the wires. We're not going to solder them so that we can have a very easy troubleshooting in the near future. Okay, so we'll now open this. Start fixing it up. Okay. So now we're gonna test our newly installed universal board washing machine. Okay. Let's put some laundry around here. Let's put the laundry. Thank you.
Dito pala dyan sound, dito ko sa...